Welcome to your library at home. I think it's not quite 7 o'clock yet, but if anybody is watching, let me know. Tonight we are making a DIY chalk paint. And with that chalk paint, we're going to make these really cute little gratitude jars. I think it's a really great time right now to find everything that we can to be thankful for. So if any of you guys are watching, let me know you're watching. And then we'll get started. So once again, welcome to your library at home. My name is Elda. I work in the Public Relations and Development Department at the library. I'm part of the Creative Services team. And tonight we're going to get creative and we are going to make our own chalk paint. So I'm going to tell you a few things that we need tonight to get started. Hi, Denise. You're saying you can't hear me? Can you hear me now? Is that better? I'll try to talk. I'll try to talk loud. Can you hear me? Hi, Debbie. Can you hear me? It's not going to work if you guys can't hear me. So let me know if you can hear me. Tonight, like I said, we are making DIY chalk paint. So what we're going to need for this project tonight is you are going to need some paint. You can either use acrylic paint. I need this wig so maybe you're gonna have it there. Oh, thanks Debbie. Good luck too. So these little 2 ounce bottles of paint are great for this project because I made this jar and this box with just that little 2 ounces of paint. So that's what we need to get started. Okay, so you can't hear me. Is anybody else having a problem hearing me? That's not gonna work out for us if you guys can't hear me. But I'm gonna keep going until I am not cold. Okay, you guys, thanks for letting me know. I can just move it closer. How's that? Can you hear me now? Audio is quiet. Probably have paint in my phone. That usually happens. Let's see if I can fix that. Not sure if I can. My volume is turned all the way up. How about, is that better now, guys? Can you hear me? And I guess if you can't hear me, you can read the directions. Here's what you need to get started with this project. So. All right. Can you hear me any better now? I tried to wipe out the microphone. I don't know if that helped, but can you guys hear me any better? All right. So we're going to make our chalk paint. I'm going to try to talk really loud because I guess my microphone is a little muffled. So what you need is basically one part water, or two parts water, one part baking soda. This is our secret ingredients, baking soda. So we are going to, this is a perfect little size, like I said, it's 2 ounces. So you could use this full bottle and 1 ounce of baking soda. So to get started, we're going to mix up some paint. And I'm literally going to use, like I said, these little jars right here are 2 ounces. So I'm going to use one of these full jars of paint. And I'm going to pour it into my little cup here. This is actually some paint that I got a while ago, free Benjamin Moore samples. It actually worked really great. So you're going to 2 ounces of paint. And I'm going to take 1 ounce of baking soda. Also, this is one of those recipes that you do not have to be exact. Hi, Kelly. Okay, so plain old baking soda. You guys are just catching up with us now. Paint, you can use latex paint. You can use acrylic paint. I'm pretty sure you can use tempera paint too. So So I'm gonna mix my baking soda in with my paint. This process takes a little bit. You guys just see literally just mixing it up. And then it's a little bit of water. You don't, oh, here I'm pouring water and there's no water in that. Sorry guys, I got water in this jar. Okay, so you're adding your water. Literally just mixing up. Can you guys hear me okay now? I'm trying to talk loud, so I'm sure everybody in my house is wondering, why are you screaming? Okay, so I'm just mixing this up. If you guys can see, the baking soda takes a while, so you have to do a lot of mixing just for the baking soda to dissolve. But it is worth it. Hi, Melissa. Can you hear me okay, Melissa? All right, so I don't know if you guys can see that. It's a little watery. It's not thick. Stir it until it's not green anymore. I have been walking through my house looking for different kinds of jars. This is a plain old mason jar. I don't know if you guys can see the ridges on this. This is a honey jar. Awesome. This was from my pasta dinner last week. This one is kind of fun because it's got a little bit of... there's numbers on here. So it says, I think, 1865. When you paint it and then sandpaper it, it comes off. So this is gonna be a gratitude jar. And I looked at it and I was gonna do some of my creative lettering on here. And then I realized it's very simple. I really like just the little texture on here. So I decided to leave this one different. I found an old, this is an old clip-on earring. Hi, Sandra. Literally an old clip-on earring. So I just wrapped it in some twine with an earring. Okay, so here's my paint. I am going to show you. I'm gonna paint this mason jar. You're gonna want to paint, and if you guys can see that, literally just painting it on there. You're gonna wanna do 3 coats, and you're gonna wanna let it dry about 8 hours in between each coat. And it's gonna look really gritty, and it's gonna feel really bumpy. But after you get your 3 coats on there, when you sand it, the grit becomes very, very smooth. So that's really kind of fun to do. All right. So you guys see, just putting my first coat on this. And now I'm going to leave this to dry. Next time I'll flip it over and I'll paint the bottom and let it dry the other way. Okay. Can you guys see that? That's a nice gray. This is going to be the new color for my office. Okay, so that's how you paint it. Let it dry. Once you've got a dry one, you literally take your sandpaper. All right, I'm going to talk really, really loud right now so you guys can hear me. Actually, especially since I'm sanding. So here's my mason jar that I did. I am literally just going to start sanding. This part seems scary, because when you start sanding, the paint starts coming off, like on here, and I was like, oh no, my paint's coming off. But when it was all done, I was like, I really like the distressed look of it. So, don't be afraid to sand, all right? I guess it's kind of good it's not really loud, because this is really, really loud. Hi, Connie. All right. Putting a lot of pressure on this. This is actually really fun to do. And I don't know if you guys can see, but it's starting to get smooth and distressed. Can you guys see what's starting to happen? Can you guys see the little bumps on there? I am using a fine sandpaper. You probably want to use a medium. Oh, good question, Denise. So this one is literally a fine sandpaper. Earlier I was using medium. Let's see if I have it here. I tend to be a little messy when I work. Any kind of sandpaper. If you have fine sandpaper, obviously you have to push harder. If you have the medium or stronger grit sandpaper, you're gonna wanna do less because your paint will come off pretty quickly. So I'm gonna try to get this off because I really want you guys to see this jar. I'm excited about it. All right, so I just took quite a bit of paint off right there and I really, really like the way that looks. And then go around the... So if you guys watched the class the other night or you watched my stamp making class last week, my idea for the gratitude jars was to make a little stamp, stamp on some kind of basic old copy paper, and then write with your, it's a great way to practice your creative handwriting. Write something every day. Find something that maybe made you happy. I know everybody's kind of getting to that point right now where every day we have to find something, even if it's something really little. Like, you know, last night my kids made chocolate shakes. Made me super happy. I was really grateful for my chocolate shake. Little things like that. When the sun shines, that makes me happy. So I might write, today the sun was shining, and put it in my jar. And if my handwriting turned out really good, that would make me really, really happy. Okay, so can you guys see that? How all the texture is coming through on this jar right now? So I would probably sand this one a little bit more. I'm excited to paint this honey jar. All right. Now you can really see that. Do you see how neat that looks? It's probably a good outdoor project though, to sand. The chalk paint is really dusty, obviously, but now it's smooth. It's not gritty anymore. I would probably then, I've just got some plain old, this is a kind of fun rope. It's got a little bit of gold in it. I'm just gonna wrap it around. Very, very simple. Hopefully you guys can see this. All right. Doesn't even really need to be glued or anything. Buttons, beads. I thought about putting a tag on this, but like I said, I just decided I like mine really simple. Tying a little bit of twine around this. All right. And I wanted to show you this jar. So this is a jar I got at thrift store, which is probably one of the things I miss the most right now. It's got this really fun little bead on the top of it. So it's just an old mason jar with this little handle on it, a knob, which I happened to find. I had a bucket of knobs laying around. So I thought it would be kind of fun if you had something, just who knows what you have. Like I said, I've got an old earring on this one right here. But maybe on this one you want to put a little bit of color to it. Here's another old earring. Maybe a little yellow earring. See that? Hi, Courtney. So I'm just going to take a little bit of hot glue. This is a little yellow daisy. I'm going to put my little yellow daisy right on there. You guys see that? Pretty simple. Nothing fancy. And then, like I said, I'm going to take some of my, I have a lot of scrap stamped paper that I'm literally going to, I'm grateful for all this creativity too. It's really nice to see right now that everybody's being very creative. I'm enjoying that very much. Okay, so I wanted to show you another thing that I found. You guys are thinking you want to try this at home. Baking soda, latex paint, acrylic paint. If you only had tempera paint, you could probably use tempera paint, one part paint, or two part paint, one part water, one part baking soda, but add your water last because you don't want it to be too thin. Any kind of jar. There's an old salsa jar, my spaghetti jar. If you don't have a jar, I found an old box, which actually I want to sand because I think this has got a little design on the top, and I want to see what that looks like. I've been waiting to sand it in front of you guys. Let's see what this one looks like. And I was thinking that since you can make DIY chalk paint, I was going to make sidewalk chalk. And that got me thinking that you could probably use a very similar recipe and make chalk for your chalkboards like this. If you wanted to paint a permanent one, this would be the perfect paint to do it. If you wanted a non-permanent one, you might have to have another class. All right, so this, and you guys probably can't see that the design is coming up very, very lightly. I feel like this one's gonna take a little bit longer to sand, but you have an old cigar box. Yes, Courtney, you wanna use 1 cup of paint and 1/2 cup of baking soda, and then 1/2 cup maybe of water to 1/4 cup. It depends on your paint. My first batch, I had to add a lot more water because it was kind of old paint, which is great. Great way to use your old paint. Add your baking soda, your water, your paint, and a little bit of water, and stir it. Where'd mine go? I just stuck my hand in it too. Stir it up. Real good. I don't know if you saw this earlier, but you want it to be kind of a little runny, but not super runny, but you have to really, really mix it so your baking soda dissolves. All right. And then 3 coats of paint. Dry about 8 hours. The recipe said 12, but honestly, I was a little anxious and I couldn't wait 12 hours. So I sandpapered mine after about 6-8 hours, and they both turned out great. I really, really love this one. So if you have a jar, like I said, oh, I wanted to show you this one too. This, you know, there's a glare. This is literally an old candle jar. So seriously, you guys, you probably have a jar anywhere. Paint, latex, or acrylic. And if you don't have either of those, I didn't try tempera, but I'm pretty sure tempera paint would work. But latex, acrylic for sure. Any old household paint. This is literally old household paint. This is one of those little samples like that you get at the hardware store. Little embellishments. And as you're painting your jar, you start thinking about the things that you would maybe want to put in your jar. Things that make you happy. We're all spending a lot of time right now at home with our kids. And they do little things every day that make us happy. So write them down, practice your handwriting, fill your jar, and you guys, send me pictures in the comments. Let me know if this worked for you, and hopefully you guys do it and you'll be successful and like it. It's really fun. It's like, the chalk paint is so expensive, so literally this is stuff you have in your house. Anyways, hi Danny. Thanks for watching, you guys, and be sure to tune in next week. I'll be on Tuesday night next week. And let me know what you guys think. If you guys have any suggestions or ideas of classes that you want to do, let me know. And I'll be happy to see what we can do. All right, you guys. Thanks. Have a good night. Bye.